I'm Srikar from Bennett University.
Hi, I'm Lakshmi Shubhrasad from Bennett University.
I am Ritik Atam of Bennett University, and our project is parking management system using IoT. We have used different components like IR sensors for detection and NodeMCU for uploading the data to the database. And for the front end, we have used HTML, CSS and Django.
Nowadays, people are buying their own vehicles instead of using public transportation to travel. Apart from pollution and scarcity of resources, parking has been a really big problem. Imagine a situation. You're working as an employee in a multinational company. There are 500 to 600 employees in your company. One day, you were late to office. You went to sell out to park your car. Unfortunately, all the slots are filled. And you wasted an extra time to search a parking slot for your vehicle. It's creating a lot of chaos, right? What if you have an automated system, a website or an app which can display the free parking slots, which can save your time? That's where we are working on, the parking management system. So let's have a brief look of the project and the prototype which we have built. This is a small prototype of our project. We are using four sensors, two of which are here, and two of these are placed real time in the parking slot, which is perfectly working. So this is the IR sensor, which detects objects. And this is a NodeMCU, which is a Wi-Fi module, which will send the data to the cloud or the database. Now, I have used Arduino IDE to send the code to the NodeMCU. This is Arduino IDE. I have installed all the board drivers and device drivers required to upload the data to the NodeMCU, and also established connection between Arduino IDE and the Firebase. I've already uploaded the code here. The reason why I've plugged in these USB cables is for the power supply. You can also use a power bank or batteries to supply power for this, because the code is already uploaded. So whenever an object comes near this IR sensor, it detects the object and sends the data to NodeMCU. NodeMCU will get connected to the mobile hotspot or Wi-Fi, whichever network is in its range, and it sends the data to the Firebase server or Firebase database. From the Firebase, the data is then retrieved by the Django website. We are using Django to build the website, so it's retrieved to the website and our user can check it on website.
Let's go through the website code. This is my base.html code looks, and I've written the HTML JavaScript code on my base.html file. So the respective styling I've done in other file, it's style.css. So I've created for every body and the division part and the inner cover also. This is my first page looks. I've named it like base.html, and the respective styling file name is called style.css. For the second page, I've named it base1.html. So this is how code looks. The URL link I've pasted here. So whenever you go through the first page, you will get a click button. So you have to click that button, you'll go through the second website. So this is how the link. So coming to the URLs, I've imported some important libraries for Django framework. One is called admin and path included. So all these you have to give request in URLs file. So the URLs patterns are this thing. So views.home and name equal to home. And the, for second page is like, I've created the name, it's called second, views.second. We have created two URLs. One is for the first page, it's called home. And for the second page, it's second, views.second. So you have to get the request from the both the pages, then only your website will be displayed with a local host. So I'll run my website on my command prompt to get a local host. You have to type python space manage.py space sun server to get a new local host in a specified environment. So this environment, like I've made a Django framework, so I have my framework I've done in separate environment called exam. So for my localhost looks, so I should copy paste this thing. So This is how my first page looks. I have showed you in my subline text. That's base.html. I've used some JavaScript. So I've told you before, I have pasted one URL link in the first page. So when I press this button, I'll go through the second page. And this is how the second page looks. There are four lanes here. When our sensor is detected a vehicle or a hand, so it displays whether it's occupied or free. So see, you will get a occupied in our lane one. It will refresh for every 2 seconds automatically. So it's visible. So it's displayed as occupied. Thank you.